Welcome back to the shop, friends. So today is the second episode of Quick Tip Monday. If you're new here, my name is Jim and I'm the creator of the Lasting Build channel. I'm a hobby woodworker and carpenter. I make weekly videos intended to help you improve your skills and inspire that next project. In case you're new to French cleat tool walls, you have a wall cleat and a tool cleat. They both have a 45 degree angle on them and they oppose each other. That allows you to hang things on your wall and move them with ease. So now to today's tip. I would recommend taking a scrap piece of your tool cleat, place that on the wall. Take your tape measure and measure the distance between the top of your tool cleat and the bottom of your wall cleat. Now, depending on what your design is for your tool cleats and the design of the cabinet or the holder, you may want to measure down to the next wall cleat or maybe even the next wall cleat. I think it looks a lot better to have your tool holder end at the bottom of your wall cleat. For example, that's one of the original tool holders that I made. And as you can see, the tool holder does not end on the bottom of the wall cleat. Now let's move on to the wall holder that I made last week. It attaches to the top wall cleat and then it comes down and it actually ends at the bottom of this wall cleat. I think you'll agree that creates a better looking French cleat tool wall. If you'd like to learn more about French cleats, I've got two videos here that I would suggest you watch. I'll see you there.